I would like to celebrate it for Catholic Charities, for all our clients, and for everything we do across the Archdiocese of Washington to promote the sense of the presence of Jesus Christ in the lives of those in need. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, prepare ourselves to celebrate the second mystery that let us call to mind our sins.
According to the decree written in the book of Moses, she is your wife. Take her and bring her back safely to your family. And may the God of heaven grant both of you peace and prosperity. When Reuben then called Sarah's mother and told her to bring a scroll, so that he might draw up a marriage contract, stating that he gave Sarah to Tobiah as his wife, according to the decree of the Mosaic law. Her mother brought the scroll, and Reuben drew up the contract, in which they affixed their seals. Afterwards, they began to eat and drink. Later, Reuben called his wife in and said, "My love, prepare the bedroom and bring the girl there." She went and made the bed in the room as she was told, and brought the girl there. After she had cried over her, she wiped away the tears and said, "Be brave, my daughter. May the Lord grant you joy in the midst of your grief. Courage, my daughter." Then she asked. When the girl's parents left the bedroom and closed the door behind them, Tobiah arose from bed and said to his wife, "My love, get up. Let us pray and beg our Lord to have mercy on us and to grant us deliverance." She got up and they started to pray and begged that deliverance might be theirs. And they began to say, "Blessed are you, O God of our fathers. Praised be your name forever and ever. Let the heavens and all your creation praise you forever. You made Adam and you gave him his first wife Eve to be his help and support. And from these two the human race descended. You said, 'It is not good for the man to be alone. Let us make him a partner like himself.' Now, Lord, you know that I picked this wife of mine, not because of lust, but for a noble purpose. Call down your mercy on me and on her, and allow us to live together to a happy old age." They said together, "Amen, amen," and went to bed for the night. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. an accident. Which is the first of all commandments? Why? First is this. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the Lord alone. You shall love the God, the Lord your God, with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. Scribe said, well said, teacher, you are right in saying he is one and there is no other than he, and to love him with all your heart, with all your understanding, all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself. It's worth more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices. And Jesus saw that he answered with understanding. He said to him, you are not far from the kingdom of God. No one dared to ask him any more questions. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We begin by reflection today by saying what a blessing after all the rush and things coming to, as I mentioned, those who have been so important these last 10 years. And I see your faces and I remember so many wonderful things that we live together. And reading and preparing today's homily, I said, well, this is like a ring for the finger. It's a message that over and over again we reproduce in our work and what we do every day for those in need. I am very particularly impressed to see the message that we get from our leader, our president. Always in all these articles for every single Friday, it is just one word, love. Love is important. As we begin to, or we continue to learn about the experience of love, and love is God, that touches our hearts and touches our lives in such a particular way, we say it's so great to be able, with that love that we receive and that experience that we get in the depth of our hearts, to be able to continue to see that love is for everyone. It's universal. This Mass is the sign of that it is just not one particular group. We are universal. We come from different cultures, from different languages. That's what this country of ours is about. What a wealth we have in Catholic Charities as we reflect the Universal Church, and from the Universal Church, we go directly to the Gospel. Love the neighbor without distinction, without making any difference of faces, or backgrounds, or cultural, or even religions. We are one, because we have been called to this world to make the real difference. And what's the difference? I guess that we await with great hope and great joy the visit of our Holy Father, Pope Francis, that reminds us, let us move from indifference to awareness. And we are the voice to proclaim the city and the five counties of Maryland, the awareness of what? To embrace those who are in need, even though we know we're not going to solve their problems. But our eyes connect their eyes. With our action, we make them human. With our action, we say, yes, God is in yourself, and I can discover the presence of Jesus Christ in your tears, in your anxiety, in your sickness. Right there is something. and something to make work for those in need. And that's what today's gospel is about. Love God, yes, very important, but love the neighbor, much more important. Because that's what really makes us leaders. When we just not only proclaim the word, but we live the word with everything we have inside of us. How has been this time for me? Hectic. I really miss you. Believe me, I really miss you. You should tell me. I really miss my boss. Don't say it loud. Because I'm in trouble. I miss my office. I miss my music. I miss everything. I just can't play any more loud music. Nothing. By the way, this is spectacular. But, you know, when I tend to be kind of, I don't know, I remember of all of you, and I know that you pray for me. And that's beautiful, because the fact that the chapel is full makes me feel very good. Why? Because I can realize that it's not the person. If that would be a person, it would be bad news. It's our Lord who calls us to do something. Sometimes it's tough. It's not easy. But together, it is not only the experience of giving love, but receiving love. And I can see that our Lord loves me in so many ways because you, dear staff, Catholic Charities. Therefore, let us continue this celebration. Let us ask our Lord to continue to give us the strength to face with joy, hope, and love the path that He pointed us out to follow. The Lord has called me, and I have said yes. I am not perfect, as Father John knows. But I have a heart for the poor. And that is what I really want to continue to do. To be your ambassador in the Archdiocese, to continue to push as hard as I can for Catholic Charities and all the wonderful staff and all the wonderful work you do. That's why we get visibility and credibility in today's world. Because our eyes, actions, and work is centered in promoting that sense of love in this world of us. Let us continue this celebration. Count on my prayers for everything you do. If you don't see me often, don't think that I'm away. I'm always connected through prayer and love to every single particular job, program, client, that you serve every day. Therefore, with that saying, let us continue to love, let us continue to proclaim the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ. And I wish I could repeat this in 10 languages. I can't, and it would be bad. But just a small word for algunos que pueden entender español. Uno habla español, se acuerda del centro, y con el centro también vemos una mayor, una porción muy importante en la diócesis de Washington, en donde tenemos que continuar sirviendo y abrazando. Saben ustedes que como obispo auxiliar, ahí hay una responsabilidad grande, cuento por caridades católicas para poder seguir animando a nuestras más de 40 comunidades parroquiales que atienden a todos los hispanos. Pero, como lo decía en mi homilía, la Iglesia es universal y como universal nos abrimos a un encuentro multicultural y multinacional. Por esto pidámosle al Señor que nos haga uno fe en Jesucristo y que podamos siempre reconocer en el rostro del necesitado la alegría y la presencia de nuestro Señor Jesucristo. Amén. we express our needs to our Lord.
Security and safety in those who are being entrusted with their care. I am reminded of the basic purpose of all that we do. We consume the body and blood of Jesus so that Jesus can move us and fill us with the fire of His Spirit in service.
Trusting in your compassion, Lord, we come eagerly with our offerings to you, to your sacred altar, that through the purifying action of your grace we may be cleansed by the very mysteries we serve through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift
up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In Him you have been pleased to renew all things, giving us all a share in His fullness. For though He was in the form of God, He emptied Himself, and by the blood of His cross brought peace to all creation. Therefore, He has been exalted above all things, has become the source of eternal salvation. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without, and we acclaim. Time he was betrayed and ended. passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Peace of the Lord be with you.
all.
And with your spirit.
Let us all reach out for the sign of peace.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Going by your Spirit, we pray, Lord, those you fed with the body and blood of your Son, that professing you not just in word or in speech, but also in works and in truth, we may merit to enter the kingdom of heaven through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Before we end our celebration, I just want to again thank Father John, our president, for such a beautiful ceremony, as well as the dear executive team, the committee, the spirituality committee. You have done such a remarkable job, and especially I would like to ask a very, very important applause for such a wonderful director.
Thank you.
They got both of them, one to high school, one to college now, so.
Oh, wow.
I'm wondering where the time went, to be honest with you. Unfortunately, yes.